Hi everyone, welcome back to Wayne's Garage. Just going to do a quick two-part video of taking set gauges out of a FX FJ dash cluster. So you can see that. So what I'm doing for my customer, Dwayne, is I'm going to be taking it apart and that, cleaning the rims up and polishing them and that by hand and that sort of stuff, which I gave a bit of a polish this morning. But I want to get into behind the glass and all that, clean it up, wipe it down, and yeah, basically go from there. Basically what we're going to do is angle that down above for you so then you can see. This is the speedo. Now I've just gone along and WD-40 the screws and all that sort of stuff to make it a bit easier to get them done. So basically what I'm going to be doing with it for him is cleaning all the rust off and that, so I've got to work out a good way on doing that just yet. So now we've taken those four screws out, the speedo should just come out like that. Now over the years, as you can see, they get a lot of dirt and dust in them, and that. I would like to probably go and I might undo the glass section to get behind it all, so then I can get there and polish up the blue a little bit, clean behind the glass, and so forth. So we've gotten that out. We'll just put that out the way. Now the little ring has a little, has a couple of little tabs that hold it in. So there we go. So there's the ring and that out. So not much to it. This one here is the fuel gauge. Now as you can see, it still has the original wiring on the back and the original connectors still, and that, so I've got to clean all that up as well. Now there's two screws for these. So there's one. Now with these they have two little tab bits that sit down and over the gauge to be able to get it out. Other than that, I may not be able to get to the inside of that one, but that's out. So put them in with that one. Same thing goes with these little rings. There is three little tabs that hold it into place, and then they're out. So nothing. Now this one here isn't an actual gauge. That one there is your temp. So if your temperature temperature's too high, the temp light will come on. Back in the day, if the generator's not working properly, the gen light would come on, and if you're running low on oil or you got no oil, the oil light would come on. So that's just basically just light casings for that, for those ones. And the same principle goes with them. As you undo these two, also has the same sort of tabs as the fuel gauge. Again, take it out. So what we're going to do is carefully take it apart. I've got to work out exactly the best way I'm doing that. I know there is a way, because we need to go through and clean the little cases in there. Yeah, there we go. With this one, it got three lips, so for this bit to come off, so you can get there and hopefully get behind it and I can have a better look. So that's that out. Once again, same thing. There's three little tabs that hold that ring in, and that. And then once you're done, that's your gauge cluster taken apart. So then, depending on what sort of finish you want, these are cast iron, if I remember correctly. So then you can strip all the paint back and polish it and chrome it, whichever one you like. Each to their own, really. So yeah, I think, if I remember correctly, these two little bits here also for lights. So when you put your dash lights on, these two here for dash lights, and that shines down into those little sections. So yeah, there you go, just a little quick one. And that, I'll be working on this over the weekend. Hopefully I'll get it done by Saturday afternoon, Sunday afternoon, and that sort of stuff, and we will go from there. Alright then, thanks heaps for watching. Stay tuned for more videos. Please like, subscribe, and share. Cheerio.